is fair. We bid thee welcome, we bid thee share. Our feasting and our reverie, our music and our company. Why is it that whenever time flies, I am left standing on the runway? Why is it that whenever time marches on, I am left doing the waltz? Why is it that time heals all wounds, while I am left wounding all heels? That may have been a bit subtle, so let me say it again. Why does time heal all wounds, while I am left wounding all heels? Time this night beware, and this a timely warning. We shall curb thy frantic force. Don't worry, we shall not actually kill time. That wouldn't be right. In fact, we may even save time, and in a nick of time, of course. So it's time we shall keep, tonight ere we sleep. Frivolity, jollity, quality time. Fantasy, fancy-free, quality time. Time that is filled with the depth of our being, time that stands still with the breadth of our seeing. Well, what time is it now? Oh, my, good heavens! 'Tis now 1490 plus 7. That's Renaissance daylight saving times, if you must know. But to make it work well, there are things you must throw. All clocks and all watches and cell phones are thrown to let Father Time make his run all alone. So, and run on he will, for time can be beat, though my rude stomach tells me 'tis now time to eat. So time stands still. No, sit down and be quiet. So I can forget for a moment my dull diet. And what shall we eat when the brass do chime? Why, parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Sounds quite silly, doesn't it? But hold on, it gets worse. Is everybody ready? Is everyone in? Then let the royal feast begin. Trumpets blow thy clarion call, and singers hie thee to the hall.
Feasting and singing.
For the general merriment of you all, may our evening of festivity recall the blessed event of Christmas, which joins us all as men of goodwill. As is our custom, King Parker and I have annually invited guests from all around the region to come and spend several days with us. Let us bid them welcome.
Masters in this hall, here we are, the yesterday has brought from on the sea, and now rejoice, I say.
Oh, wow.
us begin our feast by calling forth the wassail, so that we may wet our lips, warm our hearts, and offer up our toast.
Bring hither the bowl, the brimming brimbowl, and quaff the rich juice quite merrily. Let the wine cup go round, till the ground shall shake with the sound of our revelry.
Let the wassail and wine their pleasure combine, while we quaff the rich juice quite cheerily.
Let us drink till we die, and the saints we rely will mingle their songs with our revelry.
Wassail, wassail, wassail.
Wassail, wassail.
Happiness attend you, may every joy of the season be yours, and may you be blessed by Providence with longevity.
Hear, hear!
And to you, our most noble liege, to our blessed King of England, Lord Parker.
Hear, hear!
A toast to the lords and gentlemen, to the rulers of our person and the children of our household, to the men, I say, to our good husbands, lords, and counselors.
Hear, hear!
A toast to the ladies of this hall, to our quiet strength of our lives, to the dearest flowers of our hearts, to our wives, our sisters, our daughters, and nieces.
Hear, hear!
And a toast to our guest. May the peace and joy of Christmastide within thy hearts this year abide. Drink it well, you nobles kind, on the eve of our Yuletide. So let us toast, down with him who will not say, all hail wassail!
All hail wassail!
My good fellow, why the long face?
I do not wish to speak of it.
Someone of your size shouldn't be so down. Merton, you've got to give this foul mood the boot.
The boot?
Oh, careful, your pink slip is showing.
Pink slip?
Merton, what hast thou so fired up?
Fired? Must thou keep referring to my new lowly position in life?
Oh, come, my good man, 'tis not so bad to be you. Merton, Lord of Misrule and Attaché of Etiquette.
Oh, that I wish I were still all those things.
Well, if you wish my advice.
Actually, I don't.
I always say laughter is the best medicine.
Really?
Yes, but of course if you wish a second opinion.
Actually, I don't.
Then I prescribe revenge.
Really?
Why, yes, 'tis always work for me when I am mad at you.
Really?
Yes, of course. You're not mad at me, are you?
No, no, no.
Oh, what a relief.
Not this time.
Then revenge it is.
Verily, revenge it is!
By the way, who are you revenging?
The king.
Ah, yes, the king. He'd curdle anybody's cream. Wait, did you say the king?
Aye.
Our the king?
Aye.
Capital K, the king?
Aye.
Oh, yikes, I shall take my leave.
The fool is right. I never thought I'd hear myself say that. But then again, at least he still has a job.
Did my ears hear that mention? A job?
Aye. Who wants to know?
I do. Allow me, kind sir, to introduce myself. My name is Morgan Werechild.
Werechild?
Werechild.
Werechild.
Oh, be quiet.
The nanny position has been filled.
I'm no nanny, you ninny. I'm a great and powerful sorceress.
What do you do?
I can do many magical and mystical things. What do you have in mind?
Do you right wrongs?
I right the wrongs that make the whole world ring.
I have been wronged. The king hath fired me from my position of Lord of Misrule and Attaché of Etiquette.
Are you sure that's a wrong?
Yes, and I want it righted.
What wouldst thou have me do?
Well, let's see, if I were king... Aha! I want to be king.
Why do they always want to be king?
And not only do I want to be king, but I want the king to understand what it's like to feel my pain.
So you would switch places with the king?
You can do that?
Of course I can. I'm a great and powerful sorceress. I can do anything, except hair. I don't do hair.
So be it. I want to switch places with the king.
Come with me and we shall plot and plan.
Excellent.
And discuss my fee.
Ah, about that. Did I mention I just lost my job?
Didst thou hear that? Merton is planning with Morgan, a great and powerful sorceress, to switch places with the king. How horrible, how terrible, how awfully exciting.
It is said that long ago, a young student was studying in the quiet of Nottingham Forest, when, suddenly, she lowered her book of Aristotle to see charging at her, at full tilt, was a mighty wild boar.
Whereat she raised her book of Aristotle yet again to strike the mighty boar in the jaw with the cry, Gracum est.
Gracum est.
And as the saying goes, she choked the savage with the sage. The wise young woman brought the boar's head back to retrieve her good copy of Aristotle, and ever since, the boar's head has been borne in procession of the triumph of wit over evil.
Now, as the hour progresses, all this merriment has me growing more ravenously hungry. My good steward, we await you.
The boar's head and their eye bedecked with figs and rosemary, and I pray my master's married be Codesti sin convivio.
Guests must not stuff their mouths. The glutton who eats in haste, if he is addressed, he
he scarcely answers thee.
Guests should not pick their tea at the table with a knife, straw, or stick. Guests must not tell unseemly tales at the table, not soil the cloth with their knife, and not rest their legs on the table. Guests must never leave bones on the table. Always hide them under your chambers.
Guests must not wipe their greasy fingers on their beards. Guests must not lean on the table with their elbows, nor dip their thumbs in their drinks. Guests must retain their knives, or they will be forced to grub with their fingers.
We thank you, Lord Steward and Chamberlains. Now let us feast. My good prince, we await you.
Before the feast, we thank our God for friends and loved ones dear, who gather in this hall as the holidays draw near.
Our heads we bow, our hands we fold, our hearts we offer as of old, in thanks for food and fellowship and shelter from the cold.
Switched places.
You will be he.
And he will be me.
Tell me, Murdy, just how are you going to do that?
With the help of a great and powerful sorceress. Morgan Werechild.
Werechild?
Werechild.
Their child.
Oh, be quiet.
The nanny? She's no nanny, you ninny. She's a great and powerful sorceress.
Well, if she's so great and powerful...
She doesn't do hair.
Oh.
Here, you take these and go get a lock of the king's hair. I'm gonna go get the rest of what's on this list. Navel lint, a pocket comb, and a hard-boiled egg.
Oh, are you serious about this? I must tell the king. Sire, sire!
Ah, good fool. Why the shears? Doth someone need a haircut?
It's Merton, sire.
But Merton, sire, too late. I've already trimmed him and cut him from the court.
But now he says he'll have his revenge.
What, am I in danger?
Yes, you're in danger.
But that's ridiculous. I don't even know the meaning of the word.
Danger. Now, liability or exposure to some harm or injury implies some evil or harm which one may encounter.
Ah, yes. Thank you, dear. Now, I don't want any of you to worry about me. Burtonsire, the ex-Lord of Misrule and Attaché of Etiquette, couldn't hurt a fly. And that pretty boy certainly shan't hurt me. Why, he's nothing but a big chicken.
Good evening, Mr. Most Regalness and Mrs. Most Regalness.
Burtonsire.
Ah, remembered.
I also remember firing you earlier today.
So you did, my most divine and controlling leader over all things small and not so important ship. But before I clean out my very tidy dungeon, I have for you one final gift. A great and powerful sorceress! Morgan Werechild.
Werechild?
Werechild. Werechild.
The nanny?
She's no nanny, you know. Your nobleness. She's a great and powerful sorceress.
Goody. Ah. Entertainment.
For my first spell, I shall need a pocket comb, a hard-boiled egg, and some navel lint. Where did you get the navel lint?
Right here.
And now I need a lock of hair.
Well done.
If this mighty transmogrification spell is to work at all, I need some help. Everyone, hold hands with the person. Social distancing. Air high five the person next to you.
Murdy, I have something to tell you.
Oh, yes, good job on the hair. I won't forget you when I'm king.
It's not the king's hair.
What? Whose is it? Mine? Oh, no. Excuse me.
Yes?
Say that lock of the king's hair wasn't actually the king's, but my own. What would happen then?
The king would turn into you.
Excellent.
This is a powerful spell, and so I shall require the assistance of everyone in the room. Please, repeat after me. The winds that move from east to west...
The winds that move from east to west...
Look down on us and grant my request.
Look down on us and grant my request.
Skin will tingle and nose hairs twitch...
Skin will tingle and nose hairs twitch.
Do your best and begin the switch.
Do your best and begin the switch.
I'm alive! I'm alive! Ah! The king is a chicken!
The king is a chicken?
I thought you said the king would turn into me!
He did, don't you see? Drat! My spells are always a bit too literal.
This is not what I wanted! This is not what I wanted at all! Change him back and make me king!
England cannot be ruled by a chicken.
What's fair is foul, and what's foul is fair.
Spike, spike, squat!
Oh dear, I shall do what I can to reverse what I did. Air high five and repeat after me. The winds that move from west to east.
The winds that move from west to east.
We didn't want this chicken feast.
We didn't want this chicken feast.
Forgive us of our earthly greed.
Forgive us of our earthly greed.
Return the beast to human, lest he be fricasseed.
Return the beast to human, lest he be fricasseed.
Stop! I'm not a chicken, I'm a person.
Sorry we ruffled your feathers, your Lord Poultriness.
Get out, you little worm, before I fricassee you over an open pit.
Forgive me, your royal wingedness, but I did change you back. Why, he's as mad as a wet hen.
Hey, your spell changed the jester into a completely different person.
Whoa, can you change me back too?
Not until December 22nd due to quarantine guidelines.
Fair enough.
And you made the queen and the princess and another random person completely vanish.
Yikes. Okay, not my best work, but cut me some slack. I graduated from New Pal.
Jester.
Yes, sire? You've grown?
Jester, you were right. Never thought I'd hear myself say that. What the devil do I do now?
Well, listen, your majesty. I've hatched a plan. I'm going to be the king.
They always want to be king.
And you shall be the fool. 'Tis not a permanent change, of course, but we must protect you from Merton's evil plot to change places with you.
Good idea. The king is a fool.
Now, in order for this to work, you guys must treat me as the king and him as the fool.
Can't be too hard.
Art imitates life.
Well then, it's done. Let's eat.
Wonderful. All this nonsense has given me a royal hunger.
No, not you, fool. I am the king. I am to eat. You are the fool. You make merry.
But how can I be funny on an empty stomach?
You know, I've asked myself that question several times.
Let us hear it, fool.
What hast thou to tickle our tummies and trick our wits?
Go on, be funny. Entertain me, jester.
Ah, here's one. My dog hath no nose. Then how doth he smell? It smells terrible.
This isn't going to work.
Good people, let us eat to get the foul taste out of our mouths.
So terribly base. I do not deserve to grace upon your magnificence.
What? Guards, take him away.
Wait, I like what I'm hearing.
No, take him away.
Wait, are you gonna listen to me, a large and somewhat powerful king, or are you gonna listen to him, a recently lowly and not so funny jester? Continue.
Continue?
I am so great, you are so horrible.
Ah, yes, yes. You are so great and I am so horrible. I cannot begin to compare myself to you.
Try.
Very well then. I am nothing but a wart on the belly of a dirty little earthworm. You are like a bald eagle soaring through the sky, swooping and diving gracefully.
And let's see how that groveling was scored by the judges. 7, 7, 6.5, 6.5, 7.5, 7.
Okay. I am nothing but a hairy little beetle on my stomach crawling through the putrid gutter of life. You are like the gold-tipped point of Cupid's arrow, piercing the hearts of all you see, filling them with instant love and joy.
9, 8.5, 8.5, 9.5, 10. Ooh, and a 10 from the Duke of Orkney, a notoriously tough judge.
A very good show indeed. Now back to Merton at courtside.
With scores like that, I should get my job back.
Well, no, you're still fired. I just won't kill you.
Too bad, Merton. I would have given you your job back.
Oh, don't tell me you believe that rubbish.
Rubbish?
Yes, I expected the king to fall for such drivel, but not you. The king is so stupid, he would fall for anything.
Really?
Say, funny boy, what was that about you calling the guards to take me away earlier?
That was just a joke.
A joke? Ha! Oh, that is funny. Keep that up and I'll keep you around when I'm king.
Still planning on being king?
Yes. And this time, there's gonna be no magical spells or navel lint or pocket combs. It's gonna be quick, and it's gonna be clean. I guess you could say that my being king is in the bag.
So, Merton, we are ready for Plan B.
Excellent. This must work better than last time.
Don't threaten me, you silly man. Remember, my half of the spell worked. It's not my fault that deep down you're just a big chicken.
I am not a big chicken.
Boo. Of course you're not a big chicken. Merton, allow me to introduce my associates.
This is Stout, and this is Barley. Come on, you big beefcakes, get the lead out!
It's snack time.
What?
It's snack time.
Well, I guess we can pick up some snacks on the way, I guess.
We don't move without snacks.
High maintenance thugs! I think I might have some pretzels in here.
Flamin' Hot Cheetos!
Excuse me?
Flamin' Hot Cheetos. That bold and cheesy flavor really gets us going.
Gosh, millennials these days are so entitled.
Actually, we're Generation Z.
Most experts agree that that generation ends in the late 90s, while Barley here and I, we were born in the early 2000s.
Aha! Creamy jalapeno Cheetos.
Give me those.
Well?
Bold. And cheesy. Okay. We'll let it slide.
But just this once.
How gracious of you.
We're wasting valuable thug time. Let's go get the king.
Go get the king.
Lords and ladies, goodly gents one and all.
You're still here?
I just keep turning up like a bad penny or a wood farthing. But while we're all in a jovial mood, let us continue to make merry. Let's give it up for the suddenly funny jester.
I couldn't.
Oh, sure you could. Come on, everybody, one more round of applause for the jester.
A wizard walks into a bar.
Louder! We can't hear you, your funniness.
A wizard walks into a bar, takes off his hat, and goes to the bartender. The bartender sees a toad on his head and asks, "Where'd you get that?" The toad replies, "Camelot."
Oh, that was good. Oh, that was good. Another.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Dwayne.
Dwayne who?
Dwayne the bathtub. I'm drowning.
Oh, boy.
The other day, a peasant walked up to me and said,
"Please, sir, I haven't had a bite in 3 days.
So I bit him. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Banana.
Banana who?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Banana.
Banana who?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Orange.
Orange who?
Orange, you glad I didn't say banana?
Ah!
The king is my king now.
Oh, no. Well, the kingdom must have a ruler until we find the king, and I think the only logical person to do it is me. It's nice. Oh, he kept it warm. Well, now that I'm king, there are going to be a few changes around here. First, your table manners could use some work. Everybody take your imaginary gauntlet in your hand like this. Pinky's out. Remember, pinky's out. Okay. And let's have a toast to me, the new king. We'll work on it.
Merton, sire?
Ah, yes, Jester. You know, I was gonna fire you, but you've just been so funny lately. Here, tell me another joke.
Oh, it's a new one. See, it's about a sniveling coward who thinks he's actually better than he is, and he tries to become king by kidnapping the old king, but fails miserably.
I like knock-knock jokes better. You got any of those?
Oh, but you haven't heard the punchline yet. That's where the silly old king found out about the plan and then switched places with the jester. Get it?
No, I can't say that I do.
No. You will.
You will?
That's not the king we kidnapped.
That was the fool.
There's the king. Let's get him.
Jester, this has to be the worst joke I've ever heard. Hey!
Well, I'm glad that's over with.
Your Majesty, where child?
Where child?
Where child?
There child.
Nay, a great powerful sorceress. She's coming.
Fool, where's your king?
Now, which king would that be?
How many kings do you have?
Well, see, we have a king for every occasion. There was the old king, but then he became something of a fool. And then Merton tried to become king, but he was an even bigger fool. So he also was sacked.
So now you are king.
Oh, no, I'm just keeping the seat warm.
Perfect. Now I'm king.
They always want to be king.
My plan was really quite simple. Merton gets rid of the king, I get rid of Merton, and voila, I'm king.
It's a nice plan.
Thank you.
But you forgot one thing.
One thing?
Mertonsire is an idiot.
You can say that again.
Very well. Mertonsire is an idiot. How can you be sure he's gotten rid of the real king?
That's not the king we kidnapped either.
That was Merton.
We weren't supposed to kidnap Merton until after we got the real king.
So where's the king?
There's the king.
Let's get him!
You're right. Merton is a fool. No offense, but if the king isn't kidnapped, where is he?
Well, he'd have to be somewhere close. Somewhere where he could keep an eye on things. Somewhere no one would suspect.
Well done, Your Majesty.
Now, is there anybody else?
I don't think so.
Then send in the guards. Guards, there are two nasty-looking thugs over there by the names of Stout and Barley. They should have three large sacks with them. Bring them to me.
Begging your pardon, my liege, but two thugs, there's bound to be violence.
And three sacks.
Sacks and violence!
Sounds like fun.
We'll do it.
Well done, guards. Oust the first sack.
Did I make it in time for dessert?
Jester, you saved my life today, and I want to thank you. What can I do to repay you?
You could get Murdy's job back.
Fool, I like to keep my friends close, and my enemies closer. We'll talk. Oust the second sack.
Do you see that?
Oh no, Hank, you let the sorcerers get away.
Tough, they don't pay me enough.
Oust the third sack.
Forgot!
What? You want me to give the job to that?
Well, you have to admit, he showed some pluck. And all's well that ends well. Done. Guards, you hungry? All right, there's your dinner. Well, now that the king is safe and sound, let the music in the royal hall resound.
My old friend, it is with great pleasure that I listen upon your music making. Now, it is my heart's desire to sing part all you lovely saints above.
Thank you.
voice by a master musician or a wizard. Do you recall that melody? Let us sing it.
Thank you.
Landlord, fill the foaming bowl until it all run over. Landlord, fill the foaming bowl until it all run over. For tonight we'll marry. For tonight we'll marry. For tonight we'll marry. Tomorrow we'll be sober.
He who drinks a small while sailing goes to bed quite sober.
He who drinks a small while sailing goes to bed quite sober.
Fades as the leaves do fade. Fades as the leaves do fade. Fades as the leaves do fade. And dies in October.
He who drinks a large while sailing goes to bed quite mad.
Let her fill the foaming bowl until it doth run over. Let her.
Let us sing a song of glad tidings with a company faithful.
Thank you. sell the DVD extras group reveal?
Yes, I did!
Bring hither the bowl, the brimming brown bowl, and quaff the right. Oh, yep. And to you, our most noble liege, to our blessed King of England, may you have long-lasting life. Hear, hear.
No, you would switch places with the king.
You can do that?
Of course I can. I'm a great and powerful sorceress. I can do anything.
Yeah, man.
The sound guy's terrible.
Alright, oh, last yeah. time.
For book of Aristotle, to see charging at full tilt with a mighty wild boar.
What am I supposed to hit her?
Yeah, hey.
Here it is. Lock of your own hair.
A little to the left.
Left?
Right.
Right.
No, left.
Targer!
Targer broke character.
Yeah. For the freeze, no movement.
King, too bad, Merton.
Yeah, I didn't know if like I should cross over.
It's okay, just stay there. Did you break my phone?
Probably a good thing we stopped.
Okay.
She got it. She almost did, but she got
okay.
it.
I did not get the insurance, so.
That's you and me, Bruiser, I heard Stonewall. I asked if she was okay. You asked at the phone.
Oh! Yes, sir!
Come on, you big beefcakes.
Okay.
Get the lead out. No, just start right there.
Okay.
Okay, but shh, right on that. Come
it's
on, my big.
It's lead.
No, it's not.
It's lead?
Get the lead out.
That's how lead is spelled.
All right, we'll let it slide.
But just this once.
Great. Let's go.
It's fine. Oh, yeah, the chair's got to be over. Continuity.
Yeah, we care a lot about that.
Man, you guys are good. Choir theater, guys. Don't worry.
Good plugs, man. Good plugs. You haven't heard the punchline yet, okay? It's when...
You got the punchline.
That's my plan was really quite simple. What was my plan?
Merton gets rid of
the... Oust the second sack.
Wrong sack.
Wait.
I thought it was.
Well, you gotta admit, you did... Let's do something.
We're so close!
As of old, and thanks for food and fellowship and shelter from the cold.
That's how you do it.